Welcome back to Juju's Bites. And today we're going to be making one of my favorite desserts. It so happens to be a cake. Cakes are very delicious, and this one is going to be chocolate cake. We're gonna top it off with a very light chocolate frosting, and then spread a little bit of ganache on it. All we're gonna need is I have in here 2 cups of flour, all-purpose, 2 cups of sugar, 1 cup of cocoa powder, and then I have 2 teaspoons of baking soda and 1 teaspoon of baking powder. I like that extra boof in the cake, what we call it, that poof. And then I have 1 teaspoon of salt. I'm just gonna dump the contents in this lovely Pyrex all out in here in my stainless steel. And we just mix it up so it becomes all kind of, you want to get it to be one color. We need 1 cup of buttermilk. If you don't have buttermilk, all you really need is like a cup of milk, and you can add 1 tablespoon of white vinegar or lemon juice to it and let it sit for about 5 minutes. If the cup of milk is at room temperature, it will curdle as fast and it will give you that buttermilk texture that you're looking for. Large Pyrex, because you know I'm a mom, and if I don't have to wash dishes every 5 seconds of the day, I'm gonna take it. So we reuse in this household. 1 cup of, this is canola oil. You can use vegetable oil if you have that on deck, but I just use canola oil. 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. I happen to have McCormick pure vanilla extract, but I think we have imitation is fine as well. We're not fancy here, so. And we need 2 eggs. I'm just gonna go ahead and crack it in there. Oh, nothing fancy, like I said. If the egg is ruined, my batch is ruined, so be it. I like taking chances in life, what can I say? I'm a daredevil. I have 2 boys. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and mix this mixture together. Let me just get this mixing, so. What makes this chocolate cake rich and delicious is I like to add about 1.5 cups of coffee, and it's gonna be hot coffee. If you don't want coffee taste, you can use 1 cup of hot water, but like I said, the coffee is gonna bring out the chocolate flavor in your cake, so it's just gonna intensify the chocolate flavor in your cake. Cup and a half of hot coffee. It's gonna go right into this bowl. Mix it on low. Mix. And you can just smell the aroma of the chocolate. It smells so good. I just wanna eat it right now. It smells so good. And this batter is gonna be a little bit on the more liquid side. It's not gonna be very, it's not a very thick batter at all. You like the smell of chocolate? You would love this. So I've already prepared 2 9-inch Rachel Ray cake pans, and all I did is I sprayed some Pam regular in it, and then I just added a little bit of powdered sugar, and I kind of just dusted the pan and shook it off and coated it, so that way when we bake it, the cake won't stick. Try to get equal amounts in both of the cake pans, but if that doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. I'm just gonna go ahead and pour that out. That looks about right. Then I'll move to my other one. Pour. Looks like I got a little right here, and then we'll just finish this one off. This is gonna go into the oven for about 40 minutes, I would say, on a low temperature. It's 300 Fahrenheit. It cooks a little bit slower than most chocolate cakes. Oh, we're back. Okay, so for the whipped chocolate frosting, what we're gonna use is 2 cups of heavy whipping cream. And I'm going to use, for the chocolate flavor, we're gonna use this chocolate Jell-O Cook and Serve. It's the 3.4 ounce of Jell-O. To add to that, we're gonna use 1/3 cup of powdered sugar. We're gonna put it in our bowl. And this is gonna be a really light, but yet it has a chocolate flavor to that. And it's just really light and fluffy. Got our stiff peaks. So it's done. That took about probably 2 to 3 minutes, I would say. Oh, I got red bowls there. Dirty Red Junior. This is Red Junior. We had a red beta. He passed. So we had to go back and get another red. It had to be red. And my son called him Junior, Red Junior. So if we have to get another one, I imagine he'll be Red Junior Junior. But yeah, this is Red Junior, and he's joining me today because the boys are taking their nap. So we're going to also be preparing for our chocolate cake. It is a chocolate ganache, which is basically an icing that we're just going to kind of glaze our cake with after we put the top coat of the chocolate whipped pudding icing. So what we're going to be using for this is about a half a cup of heavy whipping cream. I'm just going to go ahead and stick it in the microwave for about, you want it to be really hot. So in my microwave, it takes about like 30 to 40 seconds. So I did 30 seconds, but it wasn't boiling, it wasn't warm enough, so I added another 30 seconds. Come out, Red! Which one is it? It took about 55 seconds in the microwave to get really warm. And all we're going to do is just dump our semi-mini chocolate chips. This is about 3/4 of a cup. I'm just going to let this sit for about 1 minute. Let it sit. Get warm. It smells like chocolate heaven in my house, by the way, if you guys were wondering. It's melting. It's getting on. It's like coming together as one. It's creating a chocolate paradise. You know you wanna give me my kiss and hug, cause you woke up from your nap. So it's been about a minute. We're gonna just take it off the plastic and we're just gonna stir. I want that gloss. I'm telling you guys, when I say this is like the perfect chocolate cake, it is the perfect chocolate cake. I don't know, but if you're a real professional, this might be like your average Sara Lee frozen chocolate cake, but for us, you know, normal people in the world, this is what we call gold. And check that out. I mean, come on, seriously. This is the consistency that we're looking for. And it's nice and shiny and glossy. We were able to cook our cakes in 40 minutes. I let them cool down on my countertop for about 15 minutes, and then to expedite the process, I flipped them over, put them on parchment paper, and put them in the fridge for about an hour. I did not have any cake boards, so I've created one. I had a cardboard, and I was looking for something as close enough to my cake spin board. So I just used the top of one of my pots. I traced it, circled it, cut it out, and to make it look semi-fancy for all you fancy folks out there, I added some aluminum foil, and yes, it is Reynolds. Now it's time to ice our cakes. Now, usually if they're a little bit lopsided or they don't bake, I suggest kind of creating it even using a serrated knife. In my case, I got really lucky today. No such thing, they're perfectly flat. So we're gonna go ahead and use it. And I just flop it over with my hand. It's not really centered to get it centered. I just scoot it. Undress this cake. And we're going to, okay, so before I Oh, see? I'm making a rookie mistake. Before I pop that, we're gonna put some icing in the middle. Okay, so I ran out of piping bags, so what I'm going to be using instead are Ziploc bags, and I just put them inside a mason jar, that way the icing, we're going to do a slight decoration to kind of make it look fancy. And this, we're going to put the ganache in it, and we're going to cut a little bit with the scissors to drizzle it, drizzle, drizzle, chocolate drizzle, make it melt on the edge. Is that funny to you? What do you think?
From here.
What do you think?
Show you from the.
Bye. My mom is the best baker in my life.